Can vitamins like iron and zinc increase your risk of developing tinnitus ringing in the ears? That's exactly what we'll explore today in this episode of Sound Science. Dr. Michelle Neidelman Kennedy and myself, Dr. Ben Thompson, are audiologists at Treble Health, and we've helped over 2,000 people through a comprehensive tinnitus treatment program. Today, we'll jump into this article. It's a 2024 study out of Australia called The Association Between Dietary Intakes of Vitamins and Minerals with Tinnitus. It investigated the relationship between the dietary intake of vitamins and the risk of developing tinnitus over a 10-year period. The study found that lower dietary intakes of iron and zinc were associated with an increased risk of developing tinnitus. This is the first longitudinal study to explore the links between vitamins and the prevalence of tinnitus in an older population, and the data came from the Blue Mountains Hearing Study, which included nearly 3,000 participants aged 50 or older. The key findings from this study did specifically look at iron and zinc because lower dietary intakes of iron, less than 9.51 milligrams per day, and lower daily intake of zinc, less than 8.48 milligrams per day, were associated with an increased risk of tinnitus over the decade that was studied. Participants with low iron intake had a 35% higher risk of developing tinnitus, and those with lower zinc intake had a 45% higher risk of developing tinnitus. Hang on and keep watching the video because I'm going to introduce three of the most popular supplements that are sold for tinnitus and analyze whether they even contain any zinc or iron. Second key findings in the study was around inflammation and auditory health. So the findings suggest that insufficient iron and zinc may contribute to auditory issues due to their role in reducing inflammation and oxidative stress. The limitations here are that this was an observational study, so the causation cannot be confirmed with any confidence. Self-reported dietary and tinnitus data may be prone to bias, and other potential factors like genetic factors or lifestyles were not controlled for. So in conclusion of the study, it proposes that diet, specifically adequate iron and zinc intake, could be a modifiable risk for developing tinnitus, though further research is required. But if you're listening and you already have tinnitus, then don't think that iron and zinc has been studied here to treat or reduce your tinnitus. It's actually not quite that. So, Dr. Michelle, what did you find digging through the study here? Any particular interest or interesting facts that you found?
Yeah, I found it really interesting that zinc and iron in particular were the only vitamins and minerals that had any substantial or significant risk associated with developing tinnitus later on. And I think it goes back to what zinc and iron are meant to do within our bodies. So, for example, as zinc plays a role in our cellular processes and pathways, it acts as an antioxidant. It acts to help prevent and reduce inflammation, which all of those things can play a role in the function of the cochlea, the inner ear, the hearing nerve, which can put someone at risk of not only developing hearing loss, but also potentially developing tinnitus. So, the research really highlights the diet's potential role in tinnitus management, adding to both the research world as well as the general population's interest in what should I be eating to help reduce my risks of getting certain conditions or help reduce the effect that a certain condition is having on my life. And I think that there's a lot of limitations with this study. First, again, like Dr. Ben had said, it's not showing a causal relationship. It does not mean that if you have low intakes of iron and zinc, you are going to get tinnitus. It just showed that there might be some form of relationship there. But again, they were really just taking a snapshot of what people were eating for a few days in a row, once every year, and it may not accurately represent the full range of vitamins and minerals that they have in their diet. You know, I work with patients who have tinnitus every day, and I think the main takeaway is that a healthy lifestyle, which includes a healthy diet, is definitely going to be helpful. It's going to be beneficial for you feeling your best. And it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to go on some crazy diet that's going to get you from having problematic tinnitus to not having any tinnitus. That's not something that I've seen before. I frequently get asked by patients that I work with, is there something that they should be doing differently in terms of like their diet, what they're eating, what they're taking? And honestly, the answer is no. If you're eating a healthy, wide variety of foods, that's all you really need. There's no need to add any additional vitamins or supplements.
So let's jump in and review these three popular supplements for tinnitus. We know that many people seek a supplement to cure their tinnitus. There are plenty of products available marketed towards tinnitus. We're going to review three of them right now. We analyzed their ingredients, reviewed any scientific support, and decided if they're worth recommending. Just a disclaimer that we're audiologists, we're not dietitians or functional medicine doctors, and that the FDA does not regulate supplements for tinnitus or any supplements. So the marketing claims can be misleading, and there's very few fact-checking or evidence-based requirements for that. First up, we'll review Synapse XT Pro. You'll see it here on the screen. This is marketed heavily online. The main ingredients that I want to highlight would be turmeric, apple cider vinegar, black pepper, green tea, psyllium husk, aloe vera, coffee, magnesium, and calcium. There is zinc inside of Synapse XT Pro. There is not iron. From our assessment overall, there's really no ingredients proven to aid or relieve tinnitus if you already have it. It's not recommended and really lacks any scientific backing. Next up, we have Tinnitus 911, advertised to reduce tinnitus and improve cognitive function. You can see it right here on the screen. Ingredients I want to highlight include vitamin C, vitamins B6 and B12, garlic, olive, hibiscus, juniper berry, and green tea. It does not contain zinc, it does not contain iron. And there's no scientific proof that it reduces tinnitus, so really not recommended either. Third up, we have Lipoflavonoid Plus, which you can see on the screen right here. Lipoflavonoid, quite a popular supplement. It's marketed as the quote most recommended by ENT doctors, which is quite misleading, and none of the ENT doctors that I know are recommending this. It contains vitamin C, vitamin B complex, calcium, bioflavonoids, does not contain zinc, and it does not contain iron. A controlled study found it ineffective for tinnitus, and it's not recommended from us. One potential supplement to consider also that wasn't in the study we mentioned earlier is magnesium, and really that can help promote sleep and brain health. So someone might want to consider that if it's approved by their doctor in an effort to find relief from tinnitus. So generally speaking here, what we found is that the study showed lower zinc and iron levels could lead to higher risk of developing tinnitus. But if you're watching this, you may already have tinnitus and you're looking to actually get a treatment or find relief from it. So there's, I would say, light evidence to suggest that if you have healthy zinc and healthy iron levels, that's good to prevent further tinnitus down the road, but it's really not supported of taking zinc or iron to reduce your tinnitus. There's no evidence that suggests that.
An interesting point from this study was that it did look at other vitamins and minerals, like that of vitamin A, vitamin C, and vitamin E, and it did not find that those reduce the risk of developing tinnitus. So again, it's not necessary to try to change what your diet is or start to add in different supplements because it may not impact one existing tinnitus and it may not ward off future tinnitus that can develop.
Final recommendations here would be to focus on proven methods like tinnitus retraining therapy, cognitive behavioral therapy, and sound therapy treatment. That's what we focus on with our patients working via telehealth at Treble Health. We want you to maintain a healthy, balanced diet and healthy exercise and sleep habits rather than relying on supplements. Guys, treatment for tinnitus exists. There is something you can do about this. Definitely reach out to Dr. Michelle or myself if you'd like to work with our team at Treble Health. Wish you best on your tinnitus journey, and thank you so much.